Assalamu alaikum students, I hope you are all fine. The topic that we are going to discuss today is formal letters. It's very easy and I hope you would have no difficulty in understanding it. I would like to tell you all that there's some problem with my laptop's microphone. So you might face some difficulty, there might be some cutting of sound, but still, it's much better than the online classes that we took the other day, and you know, it would be just a disaster. So please bear with me, and if you have any question, you know, you can contact me. But as far as I know, this topic is very easy, so I hope and I know inshallah that you would have no difficulty in understanding this topic. So let's begin. A formal letter is one written in a formal and ceremonious language and follows a certain format. Such letters are written for official purposes to authorities, dignitaries, colleagues, seniors, etc., and not to personal contacts, friends or family. A number of conventions must be adhered to while drafting formal letters. So let us take a look at a sample format of a formal letter. So formal letters are written for a specific purpose and to specific people. And usually these are written for some official purpose. They are not written for your family. Usually when you are writing to your family or your friends, you use very informal language, and there is no particular format. You just informally write and casually write anything while writing something, a letter or a message to someone. But while you are writing a letter or even a message to some colleague or some senior or some colleague or someone from your professional arena, it is very important that you follow a certain format. As we said earlier, a formal letter must follow certain rules and conventions. Such a format helps in relaying the information in a professional way. It must be remembered that there are various such formats for formal letters that people follow. The one explained here is the one most commonly used for formal communication these days. So it's easy that whenever you are writing a formal letter, it's always written in a professional manner, it's always written in a professional way, and different companies or different professional arenas follows different formats, but there's a common format that we will discuss now. Most of the professional people follow the following format that we are going to discuss. Okay, so these are two formal letters. Okay, these are samples of two formal letters. You can see these. And now we'll discuss the different parts of the formal letters one by one. So the first important thing is that you need to have the address of the sender. Let me get a pointer first. Acha. So the first thing which is important is that you need to write the sender's address. Okay, this is the sender's address. The sender's address is usually put on top right hand corner of the page, as has been written in this sample letter. The address should be complete and accurate in case the recipient of the letter wishes to get in touch with the sender for further communication. So it is very important that whenever you are writing a letter to someone, you write your own address. As you are the sender, you should write a complete address on the right side, top right side of the page. Then we have the date. The sender's address is followed by the date below it, that is on the right side of the page. This is the date on which the letter is being written. It is important in formal letters as they are often kept on record. So it is very important that when you write the sender's address or your address, you should it should be followed with a date. And dates are important because these are usually kept in record. Formal letters often are required for future uses. So it is very important that you mention the date on which you have written the letter. Then on the left side of the page, on this place, following the sender's address and the date, you write the address of the receiver. So after leaving some space, we print the receiver's address on the left side of the page. Whether to write to above the address depends on the writer's preference. Make sure you write the official title, name, position, address, etc. of the receiver as the first line of the address. So sometimes people write to TO here in this space where I'm pointing. It's your choice. Some senders like to write this word and some senders do not like to write this word, so it is up to you, but you have to mention the address, complete address of the receiver. Okay, then this is followed by the greeting. This is where you greet the person you are addressing the letter to. Bear in mind that it is a formal letter, so the greeting must be respectful and not too personal. The general greetings used in formal letters are sir or madam. If you know the name of the person, the salutation may also be Mr. XYZ or Miss ABC, but remember you cannot address them only by their first name. It must be the full name or only their last name. So when you are greeting the person to whom you are writing the letter, it is important that you, because it is a formal letter, so you should not write the greeting in an informal manner. Like when you are writing to your friends, you often begin the message in a very informal way, but in the formal letters you have to mention the greeting in a very formal way. It is better that you use a word such as dear sir or dear madam. If you know the name of that person, you can use the name of that person. For instance, let's suppose the name of the receiver is Mr. Javed Khan. So either you can write dear Mr. Javed Khan, or you can simply write dear Mr. Khan. Okay, so this is the greeting part. Okay, then after this you mention the subject. In this letter you might note that the sample letter that I have used, there is no subject in it, but it is better that whenever you are writing a formal letter you mention a subject, because that helps the reader know what the letter is about. After the salutation greeting comes the subject of the letter. In the center of the line, write subject followed by a colon, then we sum up the purpose of the writing in one line. This helps the receiver focus on the subject of the letter in one glance. By now, I know you have written a lot of applications and letters, so you must know what a subject is and how to write it. So, so I don't think there's any need to discuss it further, but still, if there's some confusion, please let me know. Okay, so next we have this part, which is the body of the letter. This is the main content of the letter. It is either divided into three paras or two paras, that means paragraphs, if the letter is briefer. The purpose of the letter should be made clear in the first paragraph itself. The tone of the content should be formal. Do not use any flowery language. Another point to keep in mind is that the letter should be concise and to the point, and always be respectful and considerate in your language, no matter what the subject of your letter is. So it is very important that whenever you are writing the main letter, your language should not be flowery. Aapko makhan nahi lagana. You should write in a very formal manner. You should use formal words. There should be no flowery language, and your letter should be brief and concise. It should be to the point, and don't add unnecessary details in it. Then we have this part, which means closing the letter. At the end of your letter, we write a complimentary name or losing. The words yours faithfully or yours sincerely are printed on the right side of the paper. Generally, we use the letter, it's not letter, L-A-T-T-E-R, if the writer knows the name of the person. So, usually, let's suppose you are writing on behalf of someone else. Let's suppose you are writing the letter on behalf of your boss. So you can write the name of your boss here. But let's suppose you are writing the letter yourself and the receiver should know that this letter comes from you, then you can write your name here. So that's about it. This is the lecture for today. I hope you have understood everything. If there's any confusion, again, I would say, please let me know and I'll help you get rid of the confusion. Thank you so much.